We the students of BGR Government Degree College Narayanguda, BA second year, are going to present the Jignasa study project on historical review of temples in Hyderabad city. My name is Haritejo and I'll be doing the introduction and the objectives of the project. From the dawn of civilizations, the temples have been the hotspots of not only the knowledge and culture but also of devotion and spirituality. The Telangana region was ruled by Shatavahanas, Chalukyas, Qutubshahis, Nizams and many more. The Nizams and Qutubshahis made a huge contribution to the temples, thus the temple architecture prospered. We can understand the past economy, society, culture and through temples, motifs and etc. The Deccan region is a mixture of northern and southern Indian culture. The objectives of this project are to study the different types of art and architecture of Hyderabad city, to understand the heritage and culture, to understand the heritage and culture of Hyderabad, to analyze the social, religious, cultural conditions of Hyderabad city through temple architecture. We have chosen 5 temples to understand the significance of the temple architecture in Hyderabad city.
I'm Hemal. I'm going to introduce review of literature, methodology and significance of the temple. For the purpose of the study, we have gone through the following literary sources. Medieval temples of the Deccan, Cousins Henry. Indian architecture. Medieval temples of the Deccan, written by Cousins Henry. Indian architecture was written by Percy Brown. Structural architecture of the Deccan, written by Knight A.V. Elements of the Hindu iconography, written by Gopinath Rao T.A. Hyderabad Archaeological Series, Government of Telangana. Methodology. The study utilized both the secondary sources and primary sources for reviewing the temple architecture. We collected archaeological sources like architecture, motifs and icons. We identified some historical places, historical temples in Hyderabad. We identified some historical temples in Hyderabad. We chose 5 temples which represent the different types of architecture. For this project, survey method was adopted. We collected photographs, interview of expert persons, well-versed in temples, art and architecture. Significance of the temple. A temple is a symbolic house, seat and body of divinity for Hindu. It's a structure designed to bring human beings and gods together, using symbolism to express the ideas and beliefs of Hinduism. Types of architecture. Broadly, the temples are classified into 3 categories. They are Dravidian style. It is also called South Indian style. Nagara style is also called North Indian style. Vaisara style, mixture of North Indian with South Indian style, found in Deccan region. Now I would like to introduce my friend Anup Ranjan for further explanation.
Myself Anup, I am going to describe about the Kala Hanuman temple. Sri Ananta Padmanabhu Swami temple and Dasanjaniya Swami Kala Hanuman temple is situated on hills near Attapur. This temple is as old as 1100 years. There is a Yagnakunda sacrificial pit near the temple where Janmajaya is said to have performed yagna, and it is filled with water. It is about 80 feet depth and still it is not dried up. Sage Vyasaraya reinstalled a temple nearly around 550 years ago. And around 400 years ago, during the reign of the Golconda ruler Tanashah, his minister Akkanna and Mandana, they have reconstructed the temple. And at the present, there is a Goshala in the temple provinces. The temple is built in the Dravidian style of architecture. The top part of the temple is flat surface and it has two types of Gopuram.
Next step, thank
I am going to describe about Ranganatha Swami temple. The temple is situated in Shivaji Nagar, Secunderabad. The temple is built in the same style as it is as Ranganatha Swami temple at Srirangam, Tamil Nadu, where Ranganatha Swami temple along with Sri Devi Bhudevi gave darshanam in this temple. The temple was built in the year 1930 and the rituals are performed according to the Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. In the year 1990, Vanamamale Jiyar Swami, under his direction, took this temple and they carried out their rituals, and the temple is built in the Dravidian style of architecture. Okay. Now my friend Harish will continue the other topics.
I'm Harish. I'm going to tell you about Tulja Bhavani temple, which is located in Muralidhar Bagh, Abids. The temple was constructed by Muralidhar, on which the street is named as Muralidhar Bagh. Kanaya Parishad is an ancestor of the family named as Shailendra. The temple has Mahalakshmi idol, which is similar to the one in Tuljapur temple, Maharashtra. The family of the priest serves the temple since it is built, and their family name is Dikshit Maharaj. The temple is around 200 years old. The idol of this temple is made up of greenstone. Most of the Maharashtrians come to this temple to worship the goddess. The people who are not able to visit Tuljabhavani temple at Tuljapur, so they visit this temple. Dasara is a vital festival and celebrated grandly, and large number of people visit during this period. Effigy of Ravana is burnt on Dasara. This temple is North Indian style of architecture. They don't take any donations and no hundi is present in temple premises. Sri Panduranga Vitaleshwara Swami Temple, Regimental Bazar, Sikindrabad. The temple is more than 100 years old. The idol is carried by priest from Pandaripur by walk and was installed. Many devotees visit mainly to get solve unemployment, visa and other problems. Most of the devotees who visit are Tamilians. On the first Ekadashi of Ashada Masam and Dhanur Masam, Brahmotsavams are held. The entire twin cities, only in the temple Sikindrabad, Dhanur Masam, Brahmotsavams are held. The entire twin cities, only in this temple, Sudarshan Narasimha Swami idol is there. The most of the temples use Utsava Vigras, but when it comes to this temple, they use Sudarshana Swami Mula Virata Vigrahas. The temple is built in Dravidian style of architecture. I would like to invite my friend Biresh to further continue.
I am Biresh. I am going to explain Sri Swayambhu Chennakesava Swami Temple, Chandrayana Gutta, and observations of this project. Chennakesava Swami Temple is on a hillock. Sri Chennakesava Swami Temple is situated in Keshavagiri, Chandrayana Gutta. The Lord is said to be manifested here, that is Swayambhu, along with Sri Devi and Bhudevi. According to the local tradition, Sri Swetamashi performed meditation, and the Lord, graced with his meditation, appeared before him. Asuri Menigandhi family has been the priest worshipping the Lord since 7 generations. Next. Shiva is said to have visited this temple. People from Barkas, both Hindus and Muslims, used to participate in the celebrations. The temple's gopuram is built in Dravidian style of architecture. Next. Observations of project. We surveyed the temples and observed with the help of photographs. We observed that in Hyderabad city, people worship several deities. There are so many temples that are dedicated to Lord Shiva and Vishnu. And besides the mother goddess worshipped in the form of Tulja Bhavani also prevailed in Hyderabad. We conclude with the help of sculptures, icons and motifs in the medieval temples of Hyderabad city that society of the Hyderabad city was religiously very tolerant. Qutub Shahis and Nizams of Hyderabad was religiously very tolerant. We know that Hyderabad city is a cosmopolitan in culture, and the Qutub Shahis and Nizams of Hyderabad was religiously very tolerant. We know that Hyderabad city was a cosmopolitan culture. There was religious friendship among many sects in Hindu Dharma, and also existed a religious harmony between Hindus and Muslims. Thank you. Then we'll explain the suggestion of this project.
Most of these temples are in dilapidated conditions. They need donations for renovation and maintenance.